Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. I welcome you all in this video, which will be useful for your RBI SEBI NABARD phase 1. So guys, before moving on to the first question, which is about the global TB report of WHO, I would like to inform all of you that you can download this PDF on the Telegram channel, and the link of that channel is in description below. Also, if you like this video, if you find this video informative, then do not forget to subscribe our channel and like this video also. Okay, so now let's begin with our first question. As per the latest global TB report 2021, India was the worst country in TB case detection in 2020. In India, total TB case detection has reduced by -% in 2020. So you have been given different percentages. The right answer is 41%. So let me tell you very briefly, the focus of this report was on the decline in the TB cases due to the COVID-19 pandemic, or we can say the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic on the progress achieved to eliminate tuberculosis. Okay, so this was the impact or the focus of this report. And this report has found that there was a major decline in the TB cases diagnosis. First of all, you need to understand this thing, that why is WHO focusing on diagnosis? Diagnosis is the first stage. If you don't know how many people are infected by this disease, how will you come up with a policy? How will you provide them with the right kind of treatment? Okay, so therefore, diagnosis is the very first stage, and it is very important. And we have found that in 2020, a major fall in the diagnosis has come. The number of cases that the people who were suffering from TB could not get themselves diagnosed, and therefore we did not have a proper diagnosis and the proper number of people who have contracted TB. Okay, so now let's go into the details of this report. I hope that you have understood the premise, that is the impact of COVID-19 on the TB progress that we have achieved. And I would say that sadly we have been pushed years back in our TB progress, that you will learn while we will be going into the details of this report. So now let's discuss the details. I hope that the basic is clear. Okay, so only this is written here that I have already told you. Now let's have a look at the global scenario. There is a large global drop in the number of people newly diagnosed with TB and reported. This fell from 7.1 million in 2019 to 5.8 million in 2020, which is a decline of 18%, and it pushed back the world to the level of 2012. So all the years that we have spent to eliminate TB worldwide have gone in vain due to the 1 year of coronavirus. The next point is the diagnosis was far short of the approximately 10 million people who developed TB in 2020. Now, 5.8 million people were recorded, were newly diagnosed with TB. However, the actual number was 10 million, approximately 10 million. This is not the exact number also. So approximately 10 million people have contacted the TB, but we have recorded only 5.8 million. So this indicates that probably these many people have got the treatment only, that too at the primary level, because we are going to see the decline in the treatment also. So that is the another point that we will be seeing. But first, you need to know that a total of 16 countries have faced this decline in the number of cases being registered with TB. Okay, so 93% of the decline was in 16 countries of the globe only, with India, Indonesia and Philippines accounting for the major proportion. India only had the highest number, 41%. Okay, so this is the highest decline in TB reduction, in opposition to our target of eliminating the TB by 2025. So this has receded us back. The COVID-19 has, we can say, has reduced our efforts, have made the efforts futile, because now this is a very far-fetched ambition. Okay, Now let's look at the treatment, because as I told you that the treatment has also seen a decline. So global number of people who were provided with TB preventive treatment declined by 21%, from 3.6 million in 2019 to 2.8 million in 2020. Now here, focus guys, ye number nahi bhi yaad rakhoge to bhi chalega, but percentage is important. So you need to know the percentage. Similarly, here also, if you don't remember these numbers, at least remember this number or this percentage, okay? So this percentage is more important than the number. Next point is that before COVID-19, TB was the 13th leading cause of death worldwide, okay? Among different kinds of diseases or fatalities, TB was the 13th leading cause of death and the top leading cause of death from a single infectious agent. But in 2020, it became the second leading cause of death because of a single infectious agent. The TB is caused by this Bacillus mycobacterium tuberculosis. So this causes TB, and after Corona has come, nobody can take its place and credit. So Corona has taken the most of the lives, but TB became, or it is estimated to have the second, to have become the second leading cause of death from a single infectious agent. So do remember this thing, from a single infectious agent. Now guys, this is the data about the deaths. So in 2020, 1.3 million people died due to TB who were HIV negative, and this number was 1.2 million in 2019. But do remember this thing that I have mentioned here specifically, that this is only for the purpose of comparison. You don't have to memorize each and every digit mentioned here, otherwise it will cram your mind and it will ruin your preparation. Okay, sirf limited or strategic preparation karni hai. So 1.3 million is the death number, that death toll. And this is the toll of the people who have died due to the TB, but they were positive of HIV. Now, what is the purpose of showing you this table? The purpose is that the combined death toll takes the world back to the level of 2017. So this has a very major impact on the progress that the world had made before coming of the corona. Now guys, this is the target, this is the WHO's strategy to end TB, but we will be looking at it in detail after we will discuss India specific facts, okay? So I'm going to discuss these first. Very short facts are there, nothing much is there, okay? So India has become the worst country in TB cases detection in 2020. As we have already seen, the major share of the drop is possessed by India at 41%. Lakshadweep became the first TB free union territory in 2021 only. March, I guess, was the month when this was announced. Can you tell me that which other region was also declared as the first TB free region along with Lakshadweep? So this is your task. Do mention it in the comment section below. And this we have already discussed. India's target is to eliminate TB by 2025. But since we have seen that detection hi nahi ho raha hai, the number of the cases of the new TB cases has declined, the registration has declined, then obviously we cannot completely eliminate TB by 2025. So this is the opinion, guys. Right now, there is nothing concrete on this that has come out that we will not be able to fulfill our target. So this is the opinion. So, but you have to remember that India's target is to eliminate TB by 2025, until or unless something comes from the government. Some statement regarding the target comes from the government. So let's wait for that. But as far as the reality is there, we can expect that we would not be able to completely eliminate TB by 2025, or there are chances that this year deadline would be extended further. Okay, so now let's have a look at the targets. So these are the milestones, 2020, 2025, and these are the targets by 2030 to 2035. Don't look at these statements, because this will look horrible to you, I know. So don't look into them. Just understand the crux. What is this saying? The reduction in the absolute number of TB deaths. Okay, so what is the target of this strategy in terms of TB deaths, in terms of reducing the TB deaths? By 2020, 35% reduction was sought. By 2025, 75%. 2030, the target is 90% reduction in the number of TB deaths, and by 2035, 95% reduction. Okay. TB incident rate, that is the number of cases the people contracting the TB. 20% reduction, then 50% reduction 2025, 80% 2030, and 90% in 2035. Percentage of TB affected households facing catastrophic cost due to TB. Okay. So out of pocket expenditure is a lot in India, especially if we are talking about the health. Okay, so health services are very expensive in developing countries and least developed countries. Therefore, this is one of the targets incorporated in this strategy of WHO. So the target is that by 2020, 0%. Again, 0, 0, 0. So there should not be any household that has to face catastrophic outcomes, because the health expenditure, the expenditure for the TB treatment is so much high that the family has entered into the debt. So this burden has to be eliminated. That was the target of WHO. Okay, so this is the target list. I hope that you can memorize it and you have understood it better. Targets bahut important hai. You can cite them as your facts, as your examples in your descriptive answers as well. So if you remember them, it is well and good. Okay, so here we have the next question. Who heads the working group of central government that has been formed to overhaul the Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana? So right answer is Ritesh Chauhan, who is the CEO of Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. And do remember, this appointment was also made very recently. So this is another question that can be asked from you in the examination. Now, why this working group has been formed? This working group has been formed in order to decide on the premium rates. Guys, this has been seen very recently that many states have withdrawn from the scheme because the cost of the premium that the states had to pay was a lot for them. Therefore, they withdrew from the scheme, and some states have not even enrolled in this scheme. So therefore, the basic purpose of providing security to the farmer, to the income of the farmer, was being defeated due to the high premium rates. Therefore, this working group has been constituted by the central government, which will have officials from the state government, officials from the central government, as well as insurance companies, so that a reasonable premium rate can be decided, and they can also work on new technologies. Okay, so one area of work for this group is premium rates. The other area of work is to work on technology, to find out technologies that can be used to estimate the loss of farmers so that claim settlement can be done quickly. Okay, so technology innovation, matlab work, finding new technologies that can help in assessing the loss, the total loss of the farmer, so that the claim against that loss under the scheme can be made quickly. So this is the entire news all about. And this is all written here that I have recently explained to you. Okay, moving on to the next question. Indian Army has won the gold medal in a multilingual exercise named as Cambrian Patrol Exercise, which was held in UK during October 13 to 15. Which regiment of the Indian Army had participated in this exercise and won this gold medal? So here the right answer is Royal Gurkha Rifles. So this regiment of the Indian Army participated in this exercise, and along with India, there are two other teams as well who have won this award. But they are not very important from our exam point of view. India is the most important. So let's have a look at this this news in detail. So the exact place where this took place was Brecon, Wales. Do remember the exact place of this exercise. Now this is also known as the Olympics of the military patrolling, and this I have already told you. 96 teams participated in this exercise, and India won the gold medal among them. Who heads the SEBI's 4-member high powered advisory committee on settlement orders and compounding of offenses? The right answer is Vijay C. Daga, who was a former judge, basically he is now retired, of the High Court of Bombay. Okay, so this is an additional information, but do remember if you can. So Vijay C. Daga is the judge who has been appointed as the chairperson of this four-member committee of SEBI. The basic purpose is to work on the regulations that make the settlement process easy for the offenders. Basically, settlement is the process where if you are guilty or not, you settle your case by paying a certain penalty. So in order to boost that system, in order to make that mechanism robust, this working group has been made. Okay, so this we have already discussed. The thing that you need to pay attention to is this. So settlement proceedings regulations 2018 of SEBI. So these regulations will be the work area of this working group. So this working group will be working under this regulation and it will find out ways to make this regulation more robust. Also pay attention that SEBI is planning, but do remember this thing, it is still planning to reduce the time limit for filing these settlement applications from 180 to 60 days. But do remember, it is still in the planning stage. Nothing concrete has been decided by SEBI right now. Which country has won the Uber Cup 2021? So it has been won by China and this is basically a badminton tournament. So it took place in Aarhus, Denmark and it is the World Team Championship for women in the sports of badminton. So World Badminton Team Championship for women. Guys, there is another championship which is known as Sudirman Cup. So this is also the badminton championship of the mixed teams. One men, one women. Okay. And the party and the member countries of the Badminton World Federation participate in the Sudirman Cup. All these cups, trophies and with whichever league is there, tournament is there, do remember the sport in which that cup or that trophy is given. Okay, on that note, let me ask you that Durant Cup is given in which sport? Tell me that in the comment section below. Okay, so which country has won the Thomas Cup trophy 2021? So here the right answer is Indonesia. Now guys, this again was held in Aarhus, Denmark and this is the men's badminton championship. So basically, men's badminton championship happened and after one or two days, that women's Uber Cup happened in the same place, okay? So do remember, Indonesia has won this championship by defeating China. And in the Uber Cup, China won. Okay. Alicia Rotage has won the Paris Marathon 2021 in men's category. Which country does he belong to? So he belongs to Kenya. So Kenya's Alicia Rotish has won the men's race and Ethiopia's Tigist Memoy has won the women's race at the Paris Marathon. 60,000 athletes from 145 countries participated in this marathon. But this statement is not very important from your exam point of view, therefore you can skip this as well. But remember the winners and their nationality. So that's all for today guys. I hope that you have learned something new during this video and if you have, then do not forget to like it and share it among your friends. Thank you.